Cole Specs, you won the giveaway from last week. Comic Fam, these comics were trending this week. Another week, another list. We have an Overstreet Prescott advisor. The dude's name's Russ Bright. He owns an LCS. How you feeling?
I'm great, Tom. You know what? It is hot. It is a scorcher this week, and this list is an absolute scorcher as well. It blows my mind how many of these books have been moving and shaking. You gotta pay attention and stay tuned until the end when we have a giveaway for you guys.
Peach Momoko at number 10. Hit the subscribe button, slap the like button. We're talking Defenders number 1, the 1 in 50 Silver Surfer Black variant.
This book is so hot. Really brand new this week. It is the 1 in 50 variant. And when I saw this, my jaw just dropped to the floor.
You see the cover A?
Oh my God. The cover A, it's still a Peach Momoko. So for $4, you could get this amazing Silver Surfer. Or for $75 average sales, brand new this week, you could get the 1 in 50 variant.
One is a gray color scale. The other, the more expensive version, gets that luscious, colorful peach vibe. And if you're a Peach Momoko fan, I think this is a great time to be buying the bigger keys. Not because there is a lull in the art market. No, on the contrary, because she's doing so much work, I think members are just buying a lot of peach stuff that it's leaving open some opportunity.
I think you're absolutely correct, Tom. This is the type of thing where last year we were talking about how it was the year of the Peach, and even now, Peach is releasing more and more covers. With Marvel, there are so many great variants coming out, but this is the perfect time, while people are paying attention to all of the new stuff coming out, to pick up some of those older variants you may have not gotten.
The Department of Truth, 1 of 100 trade dress, very scarce variant that was hitting above $1,000 for quite some time. 9.8 sales put it at 761. Silver Surfer Black, issue number 4, the 1 in 25 variant. You remember it, Null fighting the Surfer with that giant sword. That book was hot to all hell. We know Null isn't gone forever. Donny Cates has said that you can't kill darkness. That book at 9.8 has hit 227 at auction.
Even the Star Wars Adventures Clone Wars Battle Tales number 1, you know it, you love it, the one with Yoda on the cover, it $150 for a CGC 9.8 right now. That is surprisingly low considering what the Raws were going for.
Keep an eye out for Eternals number 7. Peach just announced this cover. We don't know where or when it comes out, but she's teasing it, and the original artwork is available via her Instagram at the list at number 9. We're talking new Teen Titans annual number 2, the first appearance of the Vigilante.
$25 average sales, $200 high sale for a CGC 9.8, and the last time we talked about this book, we were speculating that Idris Elba was going to play this character. And you know what? He's not, because he's very clearly Bloodsport. But we have Freddie Stroma, who is going to be playing the Vigilante in the new Peacemaker show.
That's right, for HBO Max, we're finding out that John Cena's already filmed this. He's on the red carpet getting asked about it, and he's like, oh, it's already done, already wrapped up. And we know the actor attached to play this Vigilante, and it's caused an uptick in copies sold of 122% post the Suicide Squad movie, because Peacemaker, not only, spoiler alert, survives, but it was so damn good that people are hyped about his reprisal of the role.
Now, this is the first appearance of Adrian Chase as the Vigilante, but if you want Adrian Chase's first appearance, you have to go back to New Teen Titans number 23, which is also the first appearance of Blackfire.
Double key! Comic Fam, we know it's going to be about 8 episodes long, according to Wikipedia, and we're going to look at number 8 on this list, because we have some more Moon Knight spec causing a ruckus. We have Moon Knight issue number 13, the first time that we see Moon Knight fight Daredevil.
1,067% increase in copies sold this week, $30 average sales for this book, and $89 for a CGC 9.6. If you're not buying Moon Knight books, I don't know what you're doing. And honestly, this Bill Sienkiewicz run is fantastic. Every single cover is amazing. Every single story is great. And how many times, Tom, have we talked about a book from this run?
We've had so many random big keys spike, but also these kind of minor event type of books, crossovers of characters in the Marvel Universe, considering that there's a heavy spec towards Charlie Cox reprising his role as Daredevil in the MCU. Defenders, the whole Netflix crew is getting a lot of love right now because the expectation is that they're going to be incorporated at some point. Why not spec on Moon Knight? Why not spec on Daredevil and the first time they cross over? Because both franchises are being bought to all hell right now.
one more day.
Comic fam, one more day to join the mystery mail call. Support what we do. Yo, we got some comics for them. We have Betty Page, issue 3, the homage to Phantom Lady. They came in. They're gorgeous. We have virgins going out at random. We have a black, white, and red virgin, all done by Davey Go. And guess what? We have enough copies of our Ice Cream Man cover. Show it, Russ.
Oh, my gosh. The other one is so hot and such a scorcher. We had to cool you down with some ice cream.
That's right. Ice Cream Man going in every single box. We made versions of that one as well, going out at random. ComicTom101.com to join or hit the link in the description. And, Russ, let's chat about some Scott Snyder goodness.
Number 7 on the list, Nocterra number 1.
Great book, dude.
Absolutely. A really, really good read. A lot of people were picking up this book when it first came out, which is why price-wise, $4 average sales, and we're seeing $70 for a CGC 9.8. But the story is great, and a lot of people are getting behind this narrative.
An increase of 150% after Bleeding Cool spilled the beans about there being chatter surrounding this particular title. This happens with a lot of Scott Snyder's comics because he's such a great writer and able to form such a solid narrative in so few pages. Not a whole lot of exposition that's happening all at once. He spreads it around with a bunch of character development, and he takes bugs and animals and humans and makes them into grotesque, dangerous monsters in this run.
In a world that's dark, the only way to survive is to stay in the light or hitch a ride with Valentina, who is driving a specially rigged 18-wheeler with a bunch of lights on it to keep all these baddies away.
That's right, Nocterra, 10 years after the world is plunged into darkness after a cataclysmic event. This book is buzzing for good reason. Put it on your pull list. You won't be disappointed, just like number 6 on the list, because if you get a call to visit the nice house on the lake, you better go, damn it.
Number 6 on the list, Nice House on the Lake, number 1, the third print, the 1 in 25 variant. Now, these third print books have been flying off my shelves, the regular cover price books. But all of a sudden, someone asked me, hey, do you have the 1 in 25? I'm like, no, I didn't order enough copies. Well, it's going on eBay for $80 average sales with a high sale of $100. This is brand new this week.
Dude, I thought this was a Marvel book. It looks like a design variant, but it's not. It is actually just the entire lineup, the whole crew that visits the nice house on the lake, seemingly the last safe haven for all of mankind. And there was an aspect of issue 1 and kind of 2 that a lot of members of our little community here had all said, is that all of these different people who are visiting this lake house, they all are given a name, a nickname, the pianist, the acupuncturist, the doctor, you know, and you're kind of forgetting who's who. Well, this cover does you a solid and names them all and puts them all right on the cover, and you know Walter be on there too.
This is very, very helpful. I don't know if I would pay $100 to be so helpful, but I can tell you when I was reading the first issue, I kept having to flip back to previous pages to go, oh, we're talking about the artist. Which one's the artist? Flip back. Okay, that's the artist, that's the bio, that's that person. So once I get all of these people straight, it'll probably be over, but I'm gonna have loved every minute of it.
Issue number 3 was so damn good. Every issue you are filled with so many more questions. What are all of these stone symbols that surround the entire area? What is this giant black building? What is Walter planning for all of his family and friends? Well, we're going to have to wait and see. Thank goodness James Tynion IV already finished this maxi series, because he's leaving Batman and the Joker in DC very soon.
James Tynion leaving DC? I mean, this is so incredible. The whole market is absolutely unpredictable at your LCS.
That's right. It's unpredictable at your LCS. It's unpredictable at your local Walmart. At number 5, we have Amazing Spider-Man 55, the second print, the 1 in 50 Patrick Gleason webhead cover being discovered in the 3-pack Walmart grab bags.
This is absolutely incredible to me. So this book is having a renewed interest, mainly because people are finding them and pulling them out of the Walmart packs. Now, even though there are more being discovered and more on the market, the book is selling solidly for $50, $200 for a CGC 9.8, and this is an 800% increase in copies sold just because of a renewed interest for a book that was hot a few months ago.
Here's the thing. I'm not surprised seeing a 1 in 25 in these grab bags. People have been finding 1 in 50s, sometimes even scarcer books in these grab bags. That's why they're wanted. Here's the thing, though, Russ. People are finding 1 in 1,000 exclusives. They're finding the Thor Issue 1 Hidden Gem variant. They're finding the Demon Days 1 in 500 design variants. These are hundreds of dollars. The Todd McFarlane reprint variants being found in there. These are incredibly expensive. And that's not all. People are finding store exclusives that have been accidentally distributed in there.
A member of the comic fam DM'd me this week and showed me a screenshot of someone asking Patrick Gleason why all of a sudden are his store exclusives showing up in these Walmart packs.
Not the 1 in 50, like the Virgin variant that you had to stay up and attempt to get at the right time.
A store exclusive. This would be like finding a mystery mail call book in a Walmart pack.
Patrick Gleason would go on to post about how important it is to maintain your COA because that's really the only thing protecting the authentic print count. And it wasn't just his web store included. Comic fam, we got to know your thoughts about this in the comment section below. It'll enter you to win a King in Black Nick Klein variant. And let's take a look at number 4 on the list because Suicide Squad's still affecting the comic market because it's so damn good.
Number 4 on the list, Detective Comics 585. Tom and I have been talking about this book, The First Appearance of Ratcatcher, for over 2 years now.
Definitely wasn't sure how much it would maintain, considering that we knew early on that Daniela Melchior was going to be taking on the role of this character, changing the character from the comic books. Here's the thing. We actually get to see the original Ratcatcher in the movie, her father, and this book has maintained because, spoiler alert, she lives and she absolutely killed the role.
$30 average sales, $404 for a CGC 9.8 high sale, 243% increase in copies sold, and extra spoiler alert, they weren't going to kill Polka Dot Man, they were going to kill her. Oh my God, go watch the movie, guys.
I don't know who was better, Polka Dot Man or the rat that Ratcatcher hangs out with the entire movie. At number 3, we're talking about What If. We're talking about Exiles issue number 3. We have Peggy Carter going full Captain America in this issue.
Another interesting side note for Suicide Squad, the rat in the movie's name, he is credited as Crisp Rat, so like Chris Pratt from Guardians of the Galaxy. And it's awesome because we had Michael Rooker, who's Yondu. We had Sylvester Stallone, who happens to be one of the original Ravagers. We ended up having Palm Klementoff, who is the dancer in the club. I mean, really, James Gunn did a fantastic job of bringing a bunch of the Guardians into the Suicide Squad.
James Gunn absolutely killed it. And we're talking about Exiles 3 hitting $50 average sales, $500 for a CGC 9.8 after episode 1 of What If landed on Disney Plus this week.
154% increase in copies sold this week. And this is probably not the last book we're going to see influenced by the new What If television series. Now, the comic books themselves are one thing has changed. And just like that, the television series, only one thing has changed. Well, the first episode focuses entirely on what if Peggy Carter was the one that became Captain America and they hit it out of the park.
What if Peggy Carter didn't leave the room as Steve Rogers was about to enter to get the super soldier serum? Well, Steve gets shot. He's unable to complete the task, and Peggy steps in after Howard Stark says, no, I'm not getting in there. This was a $60 million operation. It would be terrible to let it entirely get foiled, and she takes on the mantle as the next Captain America, kind of Captain Britain suit design, and we really see a condensed version of the first Avenger Captain America movie just in a quick 30 minutes with her leading the charge. And we also see Steve Rogers take on essentially the Iron Man suit.
This episode is brilliant. We even get to see Howard Stark designing the Mark I armor, the Hydra Stopper.
Keep an eye out for the Marvel Puzzle Quest variant. This was a 1 in 10. It's hitting $500 for a CGC 9.8. It's a World War II homage to Rosie the Riveter, showcasing Peggy Carter as Cap right on the cover. Comic fam, this list of 10 books is fantastic. They're the top comic books in the market this week that are trending. However, there are 10 other comics you gotta know. You gotta download Key Collector Comics, the best comic app in existence. It's available for both Androids and iPhones. And there are 10 other comics on this list because we source them from a list of 20.
Number two on the list, Peacemaker number one. This is the 4-issue miniseries from DC in the early 1990s.
We got $25 average sales, $280 for a CGC 9.8. This is the first appearance of his father, Wolfgang Schmidt. We also have the first appearance of Project Peacemaker, the team assembled to stop the Peacemaker, to keep him in line and monitor him. After John Cena's fantastic role and portrayal in Suicide Squad, knowing that HBO Max is on its way, they've already completed filming. We got Vigilante coming. Why not spec on his father? We're likely going to see an origin unfold, and this book is super affordable.
This is one of those forgotten books from the early 1990s. You're going to find them in cheap bins because it's a 4-issue miniseries, and for the longest time, no one cared about the Peacemaker, and now all of a sudden we do.
Comic fam, hit that subscribe button, slap the like button. Let's take a look at number one on the list, the number one trending book in the world that just came out this week. We have Tim Drake leading it. We have Batman Urban Legends issue number 6 off the shelves. $35 average sales, high sales for $50.
Now that's the main cover, but even the cover B that Tim Drake is not on is $25 average sales. This is something that we've been talking about for a while. The comic has alluded to it, but finally we find out that Tim Drake is bisexual.
This is a character who's very introspective. Over the last couple months, he's definitely been figuring things out. Solicitations were kind of pointing in this direction, rumors circulating, and at the end of issue 6, he figures it out himself. He wants to go on a date with his friend Bernard. That's all that happens, and it has the internet buzzing.
So the writer Megan Fitzmartin actually said, "I wanted to pay tribute to the fact that sexuality is a journey. Tim is still figuring himself out, and I don't think he has the language for it all.
Comic fam, what do you think about this list? What do you think about all this comic news? Comics flying off the shelf this week. We want to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. And as always,
geek responsibly.
Enough said. Comic fam, free comic book days this weekend. Go to an LCS. Give them your business. Buy some comic books. Pick up some free comic books. House of Slaughter, where you at? Red Room, where you at? But make sure to buy something from the shops you frequent. They really go out of their way to make this day special for this community. We got other videos for you to check out, and stay tuned because Sunday, tomorrow, we're gonna drop podcast number 45 with special guest Nick from Key Collector Comics. Have a great week.